With the start of the Olympics in Rio just days away, athletes are being advised about the threat of the Zika virus. But the threat is now here in the continental U.S. This past week, health officials announced that at least four people in the Miami area had contracted Zika after being bitten by local mosquitoes. That has resulted in restrictions on blood donations in the area. And Great Britain has even announced an unprecedented advisory urging that pregnant women from that nation should avoid travel to the state of Florida. Joining me right now is Dr. Timothy Feyma. He is a pediatric neurologist with Gillette Children's Hospital. And you have made your own decision, doctor, that you and your pregnant wife should not go to Florida. Tell us about why you made that decision.
Well, even before, there's been more publicity about some of the concerns of brain damage to a fetus. There's been some discussion on some of the child neurology chat boards for a while, and it's become pretty clear that there is a risk for damage. We still don't know how frequently the damage happens, so right now it's kind of hard to know the degree to which you're gambling if you do take a pregnant woman to an area where Zika is endemic.
Now, you happen in your profession to work with children and treat children who have microcephaly, not through Zika, but for other reasons. Tell us about what actually that is and what kind of debilitations these children have for their entire lives.
Microcephaly is just simply small head. That's what it translates to. And it's a head that's three standard deviations below the normal measurements. Lots of roads lead to it, including infections, genetics, but with Zika, it's an infection. The kids who do have microcephaly do have very high rates of cognitive issues, learning issues, varying from very severe wheelchair-bound to kids who maybe just need some little extra help in school. And the rates of epilepsy can be up to 45, almost 50%.
Okay. Another advisory from Great Britain is urging people, either men or women, that travel to an area, even Florida, but Central America, or to the Olympics, that they make sure they do not have unprotected sex for 6 months. Why is that?
Well, we still need to learn how long the virus stays dormant in the system so it can be passed. There's just something very vulnerable about the first trimester, the second trimester, and if someone were to contract the virus abroad and give it to a pregnant woman, it very much could lead to damage to the early child.
And so it can be sexually transmitted.
Yes.
So it's not the pregnant woman who has to go, her partner could go.
So far it's been passed from male to female and female to male.
Okay. What kinds of symptoms does somebody who has Zika have? I mean, do you always know?
Sadly, I wish I could be definite in my answers, but I think that, you know, it can vary from no symptoms to just the kind of fever, the kind of feeling of malaise and kind of muscle pains we all get with any type of virus infection.
Well, that sounds like a lot of things.
I mean,
so you may not know. Let me ask you, you know, for people who are listening to this, who are contemplating a trip, possibly to Florida, what would you tell them? I mean, obviously you can't advise everybody, but what are some of the things they should consider?
I think that if someone is actively pregnant in the first or second trimester, even the third, I probably would avoid Florida for right now. I think that if people are planning on becoming pregnant right now, I think the United Kingdom recommendations regarding abstinence or avoidance of sexual relations that are unprotected for 6 months should be followed. Hopefully we'll know more in time, because I hate to spread too much fear. And I love Florida. I'll go back to Florida as well, but not while my wife is pregnant.
All right. And there seems to be so many questions and uncertainties that medical science doesn't know here.
Yeah, and unfortunately, sometimes research happens at a glacial pace. But the pressure's on, and hopefully we'll get more answers soon.
All right. Well, Dr. Feyma, thank you so much for sharing your story. We certainly appreciate it
this
morning.
Thank you very much.